Amazing. All right, I'm so happy that, of course, my next guest brought her entire family, all right? Not everybody, but those who could make it, and it was for all the right reasons. As you know, every single Thursday, we've partnered up with the University of Nairobi for a segment dubbed Millennials, which seeks to highlight some of the great milestones, achievements, and positive attributes of this great institution. They have a graduation ceremony coming up on September 22nd of this month, and it's going to be one like no other. The valedictorian who gets to represent our entire class is Asia Eseji, and she's here looking gorgeous as ever. Come out here, lady. Hi, Asia. How are you? Hug it out.
Good to see you, darling.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Same.
You look beautiful.
You do.
All right. So let's start at the top before we talk to fam.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at, of course, your ambition to study, to go to higher learning. When you were in high school, did you always want to come here?
It's definitely because it's the best in Kenya. Yeah. And my father told me the first degree, you'll have to do it in Kenya. So I had to select University of Nairobi.
Okay. Yeah. Looking at, of course, what you wanted to do and study here, what was your ambition back then? And did you end up studying what you wanted?
Yes. As I was as a child, I was exposed to construction works when my parents were building their dream house. So that's where my interest began in architecture. And also, I've always been interested in art, so architecture was more or less a calling to me.
Oh, wow. All right. Starting out, coming here for orientation on that first day, was it daunting? Was it scary?
It was a little bit scary.
Yeah.
Yes, because you're there with the best students, people who have A's, and you're trying to be the best among so many other great people, trying to be friends with new people, finding your path in the right way, the right manner.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you had to find your way.
Yes.
And keep focused. That's one of the things. I went to college and it was, you know, in my time, it was good times, right? And I did performing arts where it was very passionate. But for a degree like architecture, where you really have to put your head down, stay focused, study, get the good grades, how challenging was that for you in an environment that is really kind of difficult to do? New friends is always something to do other than go to class.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
It was extremely challenging. I think I speak for myself and also for everybody in my class. And our challenge was to stay alive, because it was sometimes we never knew when we will eat, where we will eat, when we will sleep. Our goal was to meet the deadline. But how I overcame this challenge is I have a very supportive family.
Yeah.
And my friends as well, my classmates. Architecture is more of a communal living. We supported each other by staying up late together. And if I was to go home, I would go home with a few of my friends so that we can motivate each other to work hard and just do the best that we can.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
And you're right, you have a very supportive family. They showed up, y'all, all right? We told them, bring everybody. The family came, and they came in numbers, and we're just so, so proud. One of your relatives is the one who's dressed so nicely today that we've just mulikat. Good morning, guys. How are you? Put your hand up if you're related to this beautiful lady. There they are, all of them, all of them. Good to see you guys. It is so, so great when, of course, you have a supportive family like you do, and something to fall back on, and somewhere to leave and go. And just how comforting was that for you over the last few years?
It was amazing. It was perfect, because even if there were some pressures, social pressures, pressures from home where you need to attend a family gathering, but they saw how difficult and how tasking architecture was, and they were like, okay, Haya, I said, we can also help you in this. What do you need us to help you with? So it was really amazing for me.
That's so great.
Yeah.
Your grandfather is here, and he's so charming, everybody. Mm-hmm. I wish y'all are about to meet the most charming man I have met in a long time. Good morning. Tell me about your wonderful granddaughter.
In fact, you have described her appropriately. She's really wonderful. Oh. And I love her very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I love all my grandchildren.
Oh.
I've also been assisting her with her practical research. We have traveled even up to Lamu together.
Wow. Oh,
and
that's,
you know,
amazing.
Lamu is a conservative society.
Okay.
If she had been alone, she would not have been able to do what she had. She has
that's amazing. He's so great. Yes. Very supportive as well. Give it up for the grandfather. So awesome. Okay. Listen, y'all. Let me tell you a little secret. Mom is sitting there telling me, Kobi, no, mami lazima unge. Sindio?
Yes.
Yeah. Mama, please grab that microphone and just say hi to Kenya.
Nampia tena.
Go ahead, mami. Salimiana tu.
Habari zenu nyote.
Nzuri, asanti.
I'm very proud of my daughter today, that she's made it this far. A few years ago, many years ago, she was in my arms like a baby, and I'm really proud of her.
Yeah.
She's really done us proud. I love you very much.
Oh my gosh, this is becoming an emotional show. I'm so happy. We are so proud of you. Everyone is so proud. I think your other relative there is refusing, but your brother's up there, and I just want to hear what he's got to say. Good morning.
Good morning to you.
Okay, great. Tell me what you think of your lovely sister. Now she's graduating.
We're really proud of her. She's worked hard and showed us work hard pays. She set the bar, and we're hoping even us, when we join uni, we can do as well as she has.
I feel like you will, definitely. Very well spoken, very well spoken. Thanks for bringing everybody. All right. Looking at, of course, the fact that Asia has had the honor and the privilege to be this year's valedictorian. It is such an amazing feat to stand and represent your entire class. When did you get that call? Did you know you were always going to be?
No, actually, it came as a surprise.
Uh-huh.
I was so surprised. I was texted. Actually, Humphrey Webuye called me, but I missed the call. So he texted me, and the first thing I did was run to my sister. I was like, I can't believe this. Then she was praying. So I went running to my father. I even almost fell on the stairs.
This is so amazing. This is so amazing. And your sister is here.
Yes.
An amazing moment, right?
Yes, it was.
Yeah. How do you feel, your sister being valedictorian this year?
I'm so proud of my sister. I am graduating also on Friday. Ooh. And I'm so proud that she is going to represent us, the graduating class, as valedictorian.
That's very, very true. You are right. The graduation is happening here at the University of Nairobi tomorrow, actually, 22nd of September. Huge class, lots of great people.
Yes.
Is it one of those things that feels very proud for you? Is it a moment of pride just to actually have finished and to have come this far, not only just to be valedictorian?
Yes, I am. Looking back, I see now what I have achieved as a person, as an individual, and I say I'm proud of myself because I pushed myself to the limits.
Yeah.
And I owe this all to my creator, my family, my friends, my lecturers, my mentors.
I wanted to talk a little bit about that and your department. We've had the privilege of having them here on the show, actually, and I've met a couple of architectural students, and it seems like such a well-knit family and very supportive. How has the university supported you over the last few years, and what can you say about that?
The university has supported me through having this mentorship program. Mm-hmm. It's not, sometimes it's formal, sometimes it's informal. We are at such a friendly basis with our lecturers such that we can go to them to any time for guidance, for assistance, and they're always there for us. They never expect anything less than the best.
Mm-hmm.
And even our seniors, they come, give us constructive criticism, help us improve our ideas. So it's this communal feeling, communal it's lifestyle
amazing.
Of it's really amazing. And I think that's what pushed all of us, or most of us.
Excellent.
Yeah.
All right. So here at Better Living, all right, we just want to honor you, okay?
Thank
and we
you.
Just want to tell you that we are so proud of you for going through this, okay? And we actually took a moment to go and just see a day in the life of Asia on campus and what it feels like, because now you're going out into the real world. What would be the ideal place for you to work anywhere, even New York?
UK.
UK?
Yes.
Which firm? Is there an architectural firm that you want to, that you admire?
I admire Zaha Hadid. She passed away.
Yeah.
But her designs are futuristic.
She's actually my
inspiration.
She's amazing.
Yeah.
Her work is amazing. What kind of architecture do you want to do?
Futuristic architecture.
Futuristic.
Mostly urban design also.
Okay.
Yeah. Because it helps. It actually creates the cities in such a way that enhances human interaction with the buildings, the streets, the open spaces, the parks. So
okay.
That's my passion.
Governor Sonko, I know him. All right, there's a lady here. After tomorrow, she will be looking for work. Nairobi needs help, right? Don't we? Every city in this country needs help. So students like her are looking for work. We will connect you to the right people if we can. All right? But this is what we're going to do, which you're going to love. Listen to this, y'all. And this I've just thought about now. Your graduation tomorrow, we're going to give you a brand new pair of shoes.
Is it not great?
Yeah. We are. So you can just stunt and look gorgeous.
Thank you so much.
We're giving you a pair of shoes from Backyard. Okay, you can select any type that you want. You can do the stilettos. I don't know how about you feel about that. Right? Or you can do flats. You can do whatever you like. And it's our present from us to you.
Thank you so much. I highly appreciate it.
You're most welcome. Absolutely. It's our pleasure. It's our pleasure. Give it up for this wonderful lady. All right. Indeed, indeed, the graduation is happening tomorrow right here at the University of Nairobi. Many, many students who've sacrificed many nights, many days, lots of money, blood, sweat, tears has gone into this. Let's celebrate them because it's no small feat. And maybe be ready for them in the marketplace because there are brilliant people coming out of this institution.